Namaste YouTube, welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our reaction marathon to a few songs which are selected very carefully, handpicked by our family members for us to react to. We will let you know the names of the songs as we go down with each reaction. The first one is starting with Sweet Dreams by EURYTHMICS. One information that I can share right now with you is all are going to be female artist songs.
Yeah, female artists which are carefully selected, my family as well as hers.
Yes.
And we are very happy and privileged to react to them. For me, unfortunately, the songs that we are going to react to, I have heard all of them. And I have heard all of them a few times.
Wow.
Kirti has heard one. Okay. When that comes, she will mention it, I'm sure.
I will know, for sure.
Yeah, but for now, I know that she's not heard a couple of them at least.
Okay.
For sure, but she has heard one, and both of us, I've heard all of them. So we'll focus mainly on Kirti's reaction, and it is only fitting that she gives a pure reaction, and it's focused on her because she is a female too, and it's her channel. She is the main person who chooses requests and handles requests, coordinates with patrons. A lot of hard work gone into it. It's her love for music, my love for music, that has got us together on this channel, sharing our love for music with you and with our patrons and family members
share
and close friends
you,
who spend a lot of time giving us these requests and supporting us in every single way possible. You know, so let's get started right away with our first one. As Kirti said, Sweet Dreams by EURYTHMICS, one of the best singers coming up for you, Kirti, in the world, at least in the female genre.
Okay.
Annie Lennox. I'm sure you'll remember this name after
Annie
today.
Annie Lennox.
Let's get started. Great to you. What are your thoughts and feelings on this one?
Wow, I love the voice. I love, and especially that the way she did that. Wow. Every time I was waiting for it and waiting for it for it to come up. She has got phenomenal voice. That's for sure. Wow, Annie Lennox. That's what he said, right?
Will ever 10 to 12 lines, yeah, Annie Lennox.
Yes.
Will ever 10 to 12 lines be so profound, thought-provoking and deep?
I doubt.
What are your thoughts on them? Very quickly so that we can get to the next one.
By the way, I love the music. I love the way the music goes with the voice. It is a perfect song. You can't remove anything. You can't add anything. That's how it is. When we talk about sweet dreams, you know, do sweet dreams actually turn out to be actual sweet reality? We have to check that. When those dreams are converting into reality, the taste of that sweet turns a bit bitter, because the sweet dreams are very misleading. At one point when the sweet dreams were so sweet and you were dying for it to, you know, achieve, for you to achieve it as soon as possible, you were craving for it. Once the reality kicks in, once you are on the path to achieve it, it turns out a bit more bitter than you felt it was. So reality and dreams both have that kind of, you know, distance.
And it also sheds light on the entertainment industry in particular, but also other industries.
But
specifically the entertainment industry, the music industry, the movie industry, TV shows, etc. This is the life, and there are people who want to abuse you, want to pull you down, bully you, use you, manipulate
you. Some will be ready to be used by you.
Yeah, and some are ready to be used by you to get ahead in life.
Talk about
the Me Too campaign. This is reality. This is beautifully written, supercharged words, supercharged lyrics, a masterpiece for sure. I love this song. I have heard it several times while growing up. It used to play in the rooms of our home quite often at one point of time. Annie Lennox, one of the best voices I've heard, I must confess. I definitely had a crush on her when I first heard this song playing when I was a little child, boy.
Okay.
We move over to our next song, another song that Kirti has never heard before in her life.
No.
Another pure reaction. If we have time towards the end of this marathon, we'll definitely ask Kirti to, I'll ask Kirti a couple of questions, or maybe she can shed more light on these songs which we are hearing, because we have to take it quickly. MARTIKA, Toy Soldiers. This MARTIKA is definitely not, does not have as popular name as EURYTHMICS or the others we are reacting to tonight. But definitely she has made a name with this song.
Okay.
Very powerful song. Let's get started, Kirti. Headphones on. First time reaction for you. Never heard this before, right?
No, I've never heard the name MARTIKA.
Okay. Thanks for the family member who requested this. Yeah. We'll know your names after this reaction so that Kirti does not give a biased review. I already know who they are. Let's get started.
It's getting hard to wake up in the morning.
What is your take on this one? How did you like her voice, the music, the tune, and then the lyrics? Your take on it very quickly.
I like the interplay between her voice and somewhat childish, like the nursery rhyme, ringa ringa roses, we all fall down, that bit, you know, we all fall down, that bit added in it. That plays beautifully during the song. I liked it. It's a song that anybody will connect to instantly as soon as they listen to it. I like her voice, but most important was the lines of the song. The lyrics were the hero for me.
What did you think this was about? It started off with a talk about possibly love, you know, a relationship.
I know.
But I think it was misleading. I'm just giving you a clue here.
In the middle of the song, you realize what it is actually about. Yeah, and to make it clear for all our viewers, because they come and they have heard a lot of music along with us. You know, let's say Master of Puppets of Metallica in a female version with a feminine side, right?
You got it.
With a feminine side, this is what we are talking about here, right?
You got it. Spot on.
Yeah. So here, those nice voices of the kids almost, you know, saying like a nursery rhyme, come out and play with me, is pretty scary for me. You know, you feel like enjoying
it. What is it about?
It's about
It's about
drug addiction. It is about substance abuse and how it pulls you towards it very nicely, like kids, you know, well, you are so gullible to it and it so shows it so innocent. Come to me, let's play together. That's how it is calling the person who is addicted.
It's difficult. It's really difficult. With more than two million users currently residing in America alone, there are more than 2 million active users using some substance or the other, some drug or the other. There's probably an equal number of alcoholics, gamblers, and tobacco addicts also. So this song is very, very pertinent. It's talking about how those substances play with your thoughts, play with your mind. It calls you in, invites you just for that high. You basically are battling with your life tomorrow.
And you know, you will be ending your life one day.
Yeah, one day or the other, I guess all people who abuse or use substances like that, they all fall down. They all fall down like toy soldiers. Beautifully written, beautifully sung. Anything more you would like to add about the music, her voice?
I liked her voice. Music-wise, it was okay. It was a bit too popish for me.
Okay.
Yeah.
But there was a guitar solo too.
Yeah, the guitar solo was good. Mm-hmm. Luckily, you reminded that. Yeah.
Okay, so
that was good.
Popish sound, is it bad? But have you listened to so much power metal that you now don't like
I
pop?
Know. Am I becoming that way? I don't know.
Okay. But you like the song, right?
I like the
message.
I do like
it. How would you rate it on a scale of 1 to 10? Okay, let's get to the ratings later. Whitney Houston, One Moment in Time. Another song Kirti hasn't heard.
Wow.
Let's get started. First time single take, honest reaction by Kirti. I've heard it a lot. It's been an Olympic song. Who hasn't heard it in my generation, right?
Okay.
Kirti was probably born that year. She must have been a child when this song came out.
Okay.
And became a huge hit all over the world. Let's get started.
Each day I live, I want to be a day to give the best of me. I'm only one, but not alone. My finest day is yet unknown. I broke my heart for every gain to taste the sweet. I face the pain. I rise and fall, yet through it all, this much remains. I want one moment in time when I'm more than I thought I could be, when all of my dreams are a heartbeat away and the answers are all up to me. Give me away.
This was emotional for me. Wow.
Wow.
One of the most inspiring songs ever sung. Whitney Houston, her voice. Wow.
Right now, I feel bad that I've not heard it because it is so inspiring and so motivational. Everyone has to hear it and everyone has to keep it like an anthem before getting started for something special in your life, before a journey that really matters to you, before a, you know, a contest, a tournament that will shape your destiny, that will shape your life. Wow, those lines and that beautiful voice, the way she sings. You know, when Whitney Houston sings and that building up towards the last moment, when it, the way it goes, you know there's something coming up. And then comes the fireworks at the end. That's how it feels when you listen to her. Wow. She never, ever, ever could disappoint anyone with a voice.
It's so inspiring. It's all about that one moment. It's one of the best songs that any sports coach, sports psychologist can use to motivate, inspire, lift up the spirits of any sportsman or sportswoman out there, any athlete. This was so inspiring for so many athletes, so many sportsmen, even students from all over the world, the youth. All of them started listening to this song in that generation and they were inspired. The way Whitney Houston sings it, the words are awesome. It's pure genius, whoever the songwriter of this song is. But also the way it was, in which it was sung. I don't think there's anyone else in the female genre could have sung this as well as Whitney Houston did at her peak, which was this year. She was at her peak and this was her song. She made it her own. She called it her own. And everyone appreciated it. I don't think there's a single person out there who can say that this song did not move them. You hear it once and it will move you. It's that inspiring, it's that profound. I'm glad it was included by our family members in this marathon. We don't get the opportunity to react to some of these artists who are amongst the best-selling artists, the most popular musicians and artists in the world. Not just in one or two countries or one or two states. They're popular world over. This kind of song was popular from Tehran to Kathmandu, Mumbai to LA, Paris, good old Paris, to London. This song was popular in that era. It is still popular today, but obviously there are many more which have been inspired by this, the lyrics of this great, great song. If there's ever a song that can inspire a sportsman or student, this is that song, that one opportunity you get in life. There's so many songs which have taken from this, I can't even start to say. But it's true.
Beautiful song, beautiful spotlight.
Beautiful singing, the best singing you'll ever hear. Moving on to our last song, something hopefully cheerful, though I'm not sure it's completely cheerful, the topic, but the song is definitely is cheerful. It moved a lot of people world over once again, a very popular song. I think Kirti has heard this one, if I'm not mistaken.
Mm-hmm.
Shakira. Whenever. It's also titled Sueste.
Okay.
Let's get started.
Baby, I will climb the empty soul to come to record.
depth of the lyrics in this one. What a beautiful song, a complete masterpiece. Kirti, your thoughts?
Actually, with Shakira and with her songs, the only thing that people like to talk about is her voice and the way she sang, and is her voice
the
and
the way she dances.
Sang. And when they watch the in music the video, oh, the breathtaking beauty and looks that she has. That's all people talk, but this music also is phenomenal. That tune that starts the song, you can never go wrong with it. Once you hear that, you know which song is coming up. The people who have heard it, they will remember it for their lifetime. This is the song that is going to play. You just play the first few seconds and instantly anybody can tell which song is coming
up. It's an international song.
Yeah, it is. It is.
Yeah, that's for sure. Wow, I think this is the best long distance relationship song. Especially in modern times when a lot of the communication happens through FaceTime and similar apps. This is Skype, etc. in the past. This is definitely one of those epic long-distance songs. You know, from a distance, the communication is going on. You're seeing each other up close, but you are thousands of miles away physically from each other.
Yeah.
Wow, beautiful song. So much depth in the lyrics, talking about her body, her face, her smile, her eyes, her feet. So many things, being at his feet rather.
Many
things in the lyrics mentioned. It is all about that togetherness. It's all about making it work when you love each other. That is what matters most of all. Yes, the statistics and facts are against you. Long distance relationship don't tend to work. But for what it's worth, this is a great song. And definitely it helps people who are in long distance relationships. This is the kind of song that will help you stay together longer. What are your thoughts on the lyrics? Anything you'd like to say before we wrap this up and give a rating quickly if you can?
Well,
for
whenever
all the songs.
And wherever. That's what it is about. Whenever you need me, wherever you need me, I'll be head over heels. That's what she's talking about. And I guess the same should be reciprocated by the partner as well.
Yeah, let's go to the ratings quickly, Kirti, because we'll be out of time. Ratings for this song, let's start with the last one first.
Yeah.
Shakira, whenever, wherever, your ratings for the vocals, the music, the lyrics.
For the vocals and the music, I will give 9 on 10. And for the lyrics, I will give 6 on 10.
Okay.
Yeah.
For the earlier song, Whitney Houston, One Moment in Time.
Oh, wow.
The lyrics, that's the vocals, the music.
10 on 10.
10 on 10, everything?
Everything.
Wow. Wow. It deserves it.
It is.
It deserves it.
Maybe beyond. You don't need a rating.
I would be shocked if you gave anything less.
No, you don't need a rating.
Yeah. The earlier song before that, Martika, Toy Soldiers. Such a very, very important topic in today's world. As it was when it first came out, probably. Mm-hmm. It must be 20, 30 years old.
Right.
And today, this problem is such a severe epidemic in America, India, as well as, not so much in India, but definitely certain pockets of India.
So many countries.
Yeah. Plagued with addictions, whether it's drugs, alcohol, tobacco, etc.
I like how the song was sung and how it was arranged so beautifully. So I would give 9 on 10 for the lyrics, 9 on 10 for the vocals, and 7 on 10 for the music. 1 point extra for that guitar solo.
Okay. What about the first song that you started with?
Sweet Dreams.
Annie Lennox, EURYTHMICS. Sweet Dreams. What are your thoughts on that? Your ratings?
I love the song. I loved her voice the most. Oh, wow, that was really breathtaking. It would be 10 on 10 for her voice and the vocals. For the music as well, 10 on 10. And for the lyrics, 7 on 10.
Because
it was repetitive.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fair enough. So those are the ratings of Kirti, a pure reactor, the chief of Enoma, who loves to listen to music from all over the world. Great music. First time listens, almost 99%. Or more of the time, just one song out of this she's heard, and who hasn't
this
heard
we
it?
Had heard.
I'm sure if any reactor out there says they've not heard Shakira's song at least, I think they're lying. I'll openly say they're lying. Yeah.
This one you can't beat.
Yeah.
Can't.
So anyway, that's it for this one. My ratings don't matter. It's all about Kirti. My ratings will be heavily biased. I love all these songs. Family members have requested them. I love them too. Great requests. This has been a great marathon. We love music, we love music, we love y'all for requesting such songs for us to listen to and react to, especially Kirti, who has not heard this kind of music. So for her, as a team member, I would say thank you for the request and thank you for the love and thank you for your time. This is it for this one. Goodbye. Watch out for more such marathons. every single week on Enoma. Watch out for it. We'll definitely be replying to requests of family members and close friends. Anything you'd like to say, Kirti?
No. At the end of this, thank you for watching.